Welcome to Wordpress. This tutorial is about single-click full site backup, import-export full WordPress site backup, backup import from another domain by using backup file URL, and easy WordPress backup solution. I use this backup plugin all the time. It is effective and it works effortlessly. First, I will show you. See, this is localhost. This is a site running at localhost. In my machine, right? This is WSP6. This is, let's reload it. This is a localhost website and it's pretty much empty kind of site. And this site is a live site on a server. Let's reload it. And this is a site. We will move this live site to localhost very easily. Let's go to its admin area as well. And then first, I will show you how this plugin works. This plugin creates a menu. All-in-one WP migration. This plugin is here. This is the plugin, all-in-one WP migration. Backups. And you see, I have already taken a backup. And let's create another backup. I'm creating backup for this website. Backup is being created. Okay. So let's rename it. Before live backup restore. So I have renamed the backup for reference purpose. Okay, so this is one file. It's in wp-content folder. AI1 WM backups, all-in-one WordPress migration backups. So this is the folder. Here the backups are kept. This is only one file, .wprews file. This is the whole backup, right? So we can copy this backup and paste this backup file in any other WordPress site in same location. Inside WP content and then plugin backups directory and then restore this backup there by manually copying the backup file. But we can also directly copy this backup file to any other domain or website, import this file there and restore it there. Let me walk you through different areas of this plugin. So under all-in-one WP migration, we have got export page. From export page, we can export custom backup to file. Click this advanced options, and here we've got certain options to check from. So export to file, FTP, Dropbox, Google Drive, Amazon S3, and there are many other options. We can export to file, it will download the file. So in options, protect this backup with a password. Do not export spam comments. Do not export post reviews. Do not export media library. Do not export themes. Do not export inactive themes. Do not export must-have plugins. Do not export plugins. Do not export cache. Do not export database. Or do not include selected files. We can select the files to not be included in export. So we can exclude comments, media library, themes, plugins, cache, database, and everything that we like. Or we can take full backup. Do not check any of these and hit this button, export to file, and whole site backup will be exported from this page. And we have got import page, import from file, from URL. If you select file, then we'll have to provide it backup file, one file, single file. That will be imported and then backup will be restored. Or we can import the backup from URL. Let's say backup is placed in any other domain or in any other website. We can give the URL and then import the backup. We can use FTP, Dropbox, Google Drive, Amazon S3, and there are many other cloud storage services listed here as well. We have got settings. From settings page, we can limit number of backups and size of backup file. if we like, keep the most recent, this number of backups, 0 for unlimited, limited total size of backups to this much MB or gigabyte. And then we have got main area, backups. From here, click create backup to create full site backup, including everything, files, database, themes, plugins and everything. Single file backup. These are my previously created backups, and I can restore any of these by clicking here, these three dots. I can restore this backup that was taken 3 weeks ago. I can download this file. I can delete this file. So I can restore this backup or this backup. You know, I can make some changes in my website and create backup, then do some more changes inside. But if something goes wrong at any point, I have my backups at different points in time. I can simply restore the site to its previous state by using these backups. Okay, so let's restore a backup. Let's move the site. This is a simple website, nothing in there. And we've got this area, backups. Let's go here and click import under all-in-one W migration. Let's import backup. And to import it, import from URL. And here we've got this site. This is a live site. And we had created its backup earlier, 3 days ago. Let's copy this URL. I can click it and copy link address. I can also download this file and keep this file in wp-content AI1WM backups and then restore it from there. But we are using this import from URL. Paste the URL that we copied from a live website and hit import. Now this blank website will turn into this. With all settings in place and everything like that website. Using this plugin, it is really easy to move a website. Process will not stop. There will be no timeout issue. Now backup is being imported from different domain, different website. So it will take some time. Backup import is almost done. Now a site will be restored. A backup will be restored. Import process will overwrite your website, including database, media, plugins, and themes. Proceed. Site has been imported successfully. Finish. And that's it. Now this site will turn into this site. So what we have to do, we have to go to settings and go to permalinks. Now I will be logged out from here. Re-login, and from permalink settings, just hit save changes. And that's it. Refresh. And now we have that site that is here. Everything same. We don't need to change any URLs or domain path or anything. So this is how you clone a website easily. We can import backup from URL. We can also copy backup to new site in backup folder and restore it from there. So this is how easy it is to move a site somewhere else or clone a website, WordPress-based website. Okay, I used pro version of all-in-one WP migration plugin. plugins, installed plugins. See, I have got all-in-one WP migration plugin, and then all-in-one WP migration unlimited extension, and then all-in-one WP migration URL extension. This is the official website for the plugin, the best WordPress migration plugin. Products, unlimited extension. It makes the plugin pro and lifts restrictions, and the URL extension that allows me to import backup from URL. So you can check it out from the official website. Free plugin has got some limits, but with pro add-ons, it's got much value. This video is not sponsored. I am not affiliated with them in any way, but because the plugin is very useful and I use it a lot, it helps me a lot. So I have created this video. So for me, for backup or to clone WordPress-based website, all-in-one WP migration is the plugin that works for me. And if I want to go back, I can just go to backups. And this is the backup that I created before live backup restore. I can click here and restore it. Proceed. Finish. And just like that, permalinks, re-login, save permalink settings. And that's it. Site is back to where it was before cloning. Okay, I hope it helped. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.